Alright, Shalom, I'm going to begin this lesson by giving all praise, honor, and glory to Yahweh, Baal Shem, Yahweh Shah, Wahar, Rakah, Kadash, which in the ancient Hebrew tongue would be the correct names of the Heavenly Father's beloved Son and the Holy Spirit. Also, would like to give double honors to my teachers, the head apostles and elders, a great millstone. Much due honors and respect to the sincere brethren out there that's also laboring in this work. And as always, want to say Shalom to the believers. You know, the Akim as well as the Akwath, which will be you brothers along with the sisters that subscribe to this truth as well. So yeah, I just wanted to go on to another quick lesson. You know, when you take a step back and assess the fact that we have been given access to this truth, well, in all reality, that would be the ultimate act of mercy, seeing that this is the bridge to our salvation and what ultimately cleanses us in the sight of Yahweh Baal Shem Yahweh Shah, as it is written in the book of St. John, the 15th chapter and the 3rd verse, ye are now clean through the word that I have spoken unto you. Meaning, we can now be counted worthy to stand before our Lord Yahweh Shah at his return, being presented as chaste virgins. And this is a luxury that our people don't have, the two-thirds of the nation of Israel. The lack of truth, which actually separates our people from their power, versus those of us who have been granted access to this truth, well, this actually brings us near unto Yahweh Baal Shem Yahweh Shah. Matter of fact, let's start off right there. In the book of Psalms, chapter 145, and starting at verse 18,